The president also praises his pick to be Director of National Intelligence. He calls Congressman John Ratcliffe brilliant and very talented. The Texas Republican served as a mayor of a small city, and a federal prosecutor. But Democrats say he does not have enough experience in national security. The position includes oversight of 17 intelligence agencies. Current Director Dan Coats says he's leaving next month. Joining us now to talk about this is Chris Plant, the host of nationally syndicated Chris Plant Radio Show. Chris, welcome back.
Hey, thanks for having me.
So Representative Ratcliffe, what do you think of him as the next Director of National Intelligence?
Well, honestly, I think it was probably time for a change there just for openers. Senator Coats, Director Coats, he's a good man. In fact, President Trump was praising him today as a good guy, said there was no conflict there. But honestly, I think it's fairly apparent that it wasn't a very good fit. And they didn't communicate well, and Director Coats didn't communicate well from the position of the DNI, the Director of National Intelligence. I think Congressman Ratcliffe, with a good background of being a chief executive on a city level, being a prosecutor, a three-term member of Congress, but a guy who is not a Washington, an entrenched Washington bureaucrat. He's still fresh enough from the outside where I think he's looking for the truth. We need more people in positions of power in Washington that just want the truth and want the facts and want to get to the bottom of a lot of things that happened over the last few years. And also, look, he's a good, competent guy. It's not as though we have barns filled with people waiting to take these positions in Washington. And we pretend sometimes that people that take the jobs are great. The Washington Post says they're great if they approve of their politics. And if they don't, then, of course, they get the Washington Post treatment.
So you mentioned, him searching for the truth. He came to prominence with this questioning of Special Counsel Robert Mueller.
Yeah.
What do you think the possibility is for Ratcliffe's confirmation? Is he going to be confirmed by the Senate?
Oh, I think he will. Yeah. I mean, Mitch McConnell has got pretty good control over the Senate. Republicans have the majority in the Senate. The House doesn't have a say in this, so there will be very little disruption for the sake of disruption, and the position needs to be filled. So I think he'll be fine in the Senate.
I was curious, on your radio show this morning, you were talking about not Russian interference, but Soviet interference during the Cold War, a brand new report. What was that all about? Why was that relevant today, 2019?
Well, I was, because my life is just kind of like this. Over the weekend, I was sitting at home reading a report by the Center for Strategic and International Studies, a boring Washington think tank, CSIS. But they produced a report on a sort of background on the Mueller report. And they covered not only the history of Russian interference in our elections and other elections, but Soviet interference in our presidential elections. And some interesting highlights were when the Soviet KGB, they had a special section that targeted American politics and presidential politics in particular. They targeted anti-Soviet voices in American politics who are typically Republicans, from Barry Goldwater to Richard Nixon to Ronald Reagan. And they had a bag of tricks. They used media allies. They used fake think tanks. They used front groups in the United States. And they love to accuse people of racism, of persecuting minorities. They accused one Scoop Jackson, one Democrat, of being a closet homosexual, and produced fake documents, produced ironically perhaps by J. Edgar Hoover, saying that Scoop Jackson was secretly gay. But their big push for anti-Soviet Republicans, conservatives in the United States during the Cold War, was to accuse them of racism, to accuse them of being bigots and persecuting minorities. And this is the sort of stuff they spread through media allies and beyond. And reading it, I couldn't help but think that the playbook is the same today. Maybe the actors are a little bit different, but honestly, the whole dossier from the Hillary Clinton campaign came from Putin's people. All the information contained in the Christopher Steele dossier is from Russian intelligence operatives.
So much to talk about. We got the debate tonight. We'll talk to you again. Chris Plant, thank you
so much.
Thank you.
Thanks very much.
Great to have you on today.
Thank you.
Appreciate it very much.